Dalimpofu uthi uRamaphosa was held at gunpoint, or in other words, the ANC, they were held at gunpoint to announce this type of leadership, that is to take the ANC forward. He's like, you guys were held at gunpoint to come up or to give us this type of leadership. And I'm like, wait a minute, what are you saying, my man? He's like, nah, these people were held at gunpoint. They wouldn't have done what they've done, right? Oh, well, this comes after, as of me delivering this article, it is because they're just now, Ramaphosa has just announced the fact that he's just announced a whole lot of changes in the government of national confusion, as we all know. So Abo Steenhuisen, the Minister of Agriculture. So we'll do a bit of deep dive there and there tomorrow, where we will just give you the brief look. I'll see if possibly today, I will see how I summarize everything for you to say, okay, this person is in this position, this one is in this position, this one is in this position, this one is in this position. But one thing that we know as of now is that the cabinet thereon has been announced. We all know Guti, a man such as Gayton McKenzie was eyeing for the Department of Home Affairs, but that department is now given to somebody from the DA, right? So he did not get what he was looking for, and he promised that if it doesn't get the Home Affairs, they will exit the GNU. But I'm surprised that it's still there, and he is now a local minister of sports, arts and culture, the department that was given to it was held by who's this person, this individual man, who's this Zigodwa? So that's just the long and short of it. Now, former economic freedom fighter, EFF national chairperson, advocate Dalimpofu says ANC had entered into a deal with Democratic Alliance at a gunpoint. Now, I need to dissect this. What does it mean to be local to enter a decision or to enter into an agreement being forced? It simply means, or it can simply put, if you translate this, just the first paragraph, it simply means that there are things that they had on you that if you did not do what they wanted you to do, the consequences were, we are going to release files and you do not want the files out. And so Ramaphosa had to bow. Well, we will not bow in this YouTube channel. Why am I saying we will not bow? It is because of this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 Rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Advocate Dalimpofu was speaking during an interview with EFF podcast, where he shared his thought on the government of national unity and the ANC's new leadership with the DA, or new relationship with the DA. He said, I quote, "The idea that the ANC is going to walk away from this deal, that is not going to happen. They are entering this deal at a gunpoint," he said. Can I repeat this? "The idea that the ANC is going to walk away from this deal, that is not going to happen. They are entering this at a gunpoint." Look, I've already explained or expressed my thoughts around that. He says, according to Mpofu, the ANC was forced by its funders to get into a governing agreement with DA. You can't disagree with Mpofu, and I will tell you why you can't disagree with Mpofu. This started in 2017. People don't give you billion rand and you think that you have a free hand. That's true. You see, I was going to say this. Now we are told, instead of people saying Ramaphosa's funders want the relationship between ETA, coalition between ETA and ANC, instead of us being told that, they swapped that, and guess what they said? They said, no, it's actually a coalition between DA and ANC. It's actually a government of national unity. But even then, you will be told that the market, they want that. But the market did not vote, are not the voters here. So in other words, it's an exchange of the words. The funders wants this type of relationship. It's not the market per se. It's the funders that wants this type of a relationship. So now they have gotten what they want. I agree. The EFF member accused the ANC of handing over the country to the DA and former apartheid leaders. He said, I quote, what Ramaphosa is doing with the ANC is opening the wounds of apartheid by force feeding us with this racist, which we know now, look on TV every day. Oh, my God. It's going to be hard to get because they are apparently here to stay. Fighting within the ANC has lost its meaning now with the last sellout of position. Someone who sits in the caucus of the ANC in parliament or at the ANC, NEC of the ANC, sits in any seat structure, sits in its structure, must know that they are part of the enemy, of the enemy forces. They are part of the enemies of our people. Oh, those are strong words, Dalimpov, because really they don't want to hear that. They don't want to hear that. But yeah, in short and simple, I will easily say, for me, I think that the people that wanted the coalition between DA and ANC really want, those are the funders of Ramaphosa, right? We, at some point when we were talking about, prior to elections, you remember that we had an episode where we talked about, where we spoke about the fact that if you are being funded by a certain type of leaders. Say, for instance, if you're being funded by a capitalist, we will see it through your behavior. You can tell that the funders of Ramaphosa are racist. Just by looking at how they do things, you can tell that the funders they're on are racist too. They want a government that looks like them. Hence, they forced the type of government, right? As we give this, But there's one lesson that you can learn there, is that nothing is for free in this world. You just need look, and I wish those people who goes around sleeping with people for money and everything, I wish they can learn this lesson that what you are learning from Ramaphosa's presidency is that nothing is for free. Right? You're going to pay for that one way or the other. That's the biggest lesson that I've learned out of all these things.